What is going on, Dragon Ball fans? Welcome back to another Dragon Ball fan manga breakdown review, where today we're going to be reviewing a fan manga entitled Dragon Ball Multiverse, which is a fan-made manga set within an alternative timeline involving various incarnations of Dragon Ball characters set within different universes and timelines to compete in a massive multiverse tournament for the grand prize to see which universe will be the universe to gain the mightiest of the Dragon Balls. As for many years now, I've been introducing and showcasing various different fan mangas created by the community for the community, so if you would like to check out all the latest and best Dragon Ball fan mangas, then make sure to check the description box and bio down below for all the latest in Dragon Ball fan mangas, including Dragon Ball AF, Dragon Ball X, Beyond Dragon Ball Super, and many others. Then be sure to check out all the Dragon Ball fan mangas listed down below, and if you are new to this channel and are a fan of anime and Dragon Ball, then don't forget to smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single upload. As we kick off Dragon Ball Multiverse manga chapter number 49 with the conclusive battle between Kakarot and Vegeta from Universe 18. As the narration goes on to state, Vegeta from Universe 18 is victorious, leaving Kakarot defeated and injured in the middle of the crater. As back within the arena, one of the tournament holders goes on to state, "I've lowered the gravity. You may go and heal him." As one of the Namekians goes on to state, "I'm pretty sure he's dead." While over on the battlefield, we see how Raditz picks up Kakarot and stating, "Oh well, he laid one on you." As he puts him back down, Raditz looks on over to Prince Vegeta and Nappa and stating, "Let's move on to more serious matters. I propose that I go and speak to the old Kaioshin by myself." As Vegeta goes on to state, "Why not? You've developed your diplomatic talents well to make up for your lack of strength." As Raditz takes off, the Namekian lands in front of Kakarot and asking Vegeta and Nappa, "I'm going to heal him." But upon making these statements, Vegeta responds immediately by stating, "No, leave him be. I prefer him like this." Basically leaving Kakarot in a pool of his own blood. As we look on over in the arena, we see how some of the spectators go on to clench their ears, as one of the women there goes on to ask what's the matter. As one of the other audience members goes on to state, "Nothing, everything is fine." While back inside the arena, one of the tournament holders goes on to state, "Cell from Universe 17 and Tapion from Universe 3 may enter the ring." As one of the other tournament holders goes on to ask, "Hey, everything alright? You having a bad feather day? You having a bad feather day?" As the other responds, "I'm fine. I just didn't get much sleep." While Raditz is talking to the Kaioshin, he goes on to ask, "Lord Kaioshin, you can know if I lie, right? So, I'll be frank with you. Your power, give it to me only, and in exchange, I'll free up my universe." So Raditz is trying to negotiate with one of the Kaioshins in giving them his power in exchange for Raditz, quote, freeing his universe. But then over back at the actual tournament stage, we see how Raichi begins to talk to Tapion, as he goes on to state, "If you step into the ring without Rudigon's aura, you'll instantly be killed." As Tapion states, "In fact, last night, I figured out a much better solution. Rap with me, your aura, and fight for me." As he finally summons Harunagod, which is pretty cool because now we're setting the stages for basically Cell versus Harunagod. As Tapion sits on back, we see the formation of Harunagod beginning to take place. And it's because of this we notice how Harunagod is looking down at Cell, as Cell goes on to state, "What a big beast. It will be perfect for my training." As Tapion goes on to state, "I'm not in control any longer, but at least I'm not my own weak point anymore." As Cell charges on in, we finally have the battle between Super Perfect Cell and Harunagod, which I will say, as soon as Cell throws the first shot, he goes on to state, "It doesn't make any sense. I'm hitting him much harder than I hit the old Krillin. What's going on?" As Cell steps on back, he begins to unleash massive amounts of Ki Blast at Harunagod, but Harunagod simply vanishes away. So Cell is at a disadvantage because if he hits him, there's no effect. If he tries to blast him once more, there is no effect. As Harunagod appears behind Cell, he instantly goes to punch Cell, but Cell moves out of the way and claiming easy. But as quickly as it happens, Harunagod uses his tail in trying to outmaneuver outmaneuver Cell in blasting him at the exact same time. So although Harutagar does have lots of hacks that perhaps Cell does not, Cell is still managing to keep up as he is able to survive the initial blast that Harutagar created. And because of this, Cell goes on to free himself in responding by stating your attacks are of ridiculous level. And he looks to be a little injured as he continues, it can last forever if none of us can hurt the other. I can go on for years against you without stopping, but what about you? As Harutagar looks down, Cell looks up and stating you're right. The audience would get bored. But that's not my problem. It's time to play on the same field. As Cell begins to power up, he also begins to grow in size. And what I really enjoy about this is Cell makes the insinuation that he could easily keep this battle up with Harutagar for as long as he wants, but instead of doing so, he believes that the audience will in fact be bored. Whether or not this is a bluff, it's really in Cell's favor because as he begins to power up and grow in size, we notice how Goku, Piccolo, and Vegeta are looking on over as Goku states he didn't do that against us. And now we have two massive characters, Super Perfect Cell and Harutagar, about to fight. And it's a really intense showdown, a really intense stare down, as both of them overlook the other. As Cell doesn't waste time in charging on in and delivering rapid shots to Harutagar's body. He hits him so hard that Cell delivers a thunderous uppercut as well, completely dropping Harutagar as the fight goes on. And again, what makes this really cool is seeing how Cell is able to adapt to even a creature like Harutagar and growing in size as well. And even then, Cell not only maintains his power, but he also maintains his speed. As we notice Harutagar laying on the floor, the Cell Juniors begin to cheer on their father, but when they look on over, they also notice how Vegito is also cheering on Perfect Cell. As Vegito goes on to state, yeah, nice combo, as Gohan states, Dad, don't support Cell, please. While the two audience members that we've seen before begin to stand up as we see them walk down a flight of stairs very menacingly. As over out on the other side of the arena, Kakarot begins to wake up. He's coughing up blood. As he looks on over, Vegeta goes on to state, already conscious, what a pain. As Kakarot says, why wasn't I healed? Vegeta, you bastard. Heal me! As he's finally healed by one of the Namekians, he stands up and stating, ah, at last, Raditz, where are you? How could you leave me? As Kakarot storms out, Nappa goes on to state he's not here. With Kakarot turning around, he goes on to cry out, Vegeta sent you to watch me? Stop taking me for a fool and go back to your kennel. You think I'm crazy, huh? As Nappa states, well, yes. But then, something very mysterious begins to occur as Kakarot looks on over at Nappa and states, but my mind has never been so clear. As Nappa also begins to change, we notice something in both Kakarot and Nappa as they both go on to state, what should we do? Master, as the puppet master behind the alterations behind Kakarot and Nappa is Babidi. As Babidi cries out, you, nothing yet. While back in the arena, as everyone else is watching the fight, Videl steps out for a minute as she goes on to state, if Dad saw this giant Cell, he'd be having nightmares. As she notices out in the back, there are a band of goons as they go on to ask, it's here? With one of the women crying out, yeah, she's the weakest of the universe. A very good hostage for us. As we notice something going on in the background, the Z fighters also take notice of this. As Gohan is about to swoop in, he is stopped by Vegeta. As Vegeta states, Pan, run to the flat immediately. Let her go alone, so that she grows up. As Pan swoops on in, she cries out, Mom, and notices how Videl was able to hand her her own. As she cries out, ah, dear, I knocked them down repeatedly, but they keep attacking again. Brings back some really bad memories. While back on the actual field, Harutagar stands up. As Cell goes on to state, he's unharmed. Hits are neither blunted or deflected. And when I try a piercing attack, he vanishes into smoke. Ah, if he sees it coming, I see. As Cell swoops on in, once more he goes in for the attack, but instead now, he unleashes an attack so fast that it actually pierces right through Harutagar. As Cell grabs him by the neck, he goes on to state, I'm not done yet. But in typical Harutagar fashion, he vanishes into smoke, but Cell being Cell, immediately picks this up as he goes on to state, "Oh no, you won't escape from me." As Cell inhales the smoke that is of Harunagarn in his body, he begins to suck away everything that is of Harunagarn on the actual field in his body. As only then we see how Cell is holding Harunagarn in his own body, as the tournament holders goes on to state Tapion's been completely sucked inside. We begin the countdown. As Trunks goes on to state Tapion, "Damn, they don't get anything." As Goku states, "Well, do you think he'll explode?" As Vegeta states, "Of course not. That has nothing to do with—" and then bam, we notice how Harunagard's tail pierces right through Cell as Harunagard rips right out of Cell's body in a very brutal fashion. As we then look at the tournament holders as they go on to stay, we begin the countdown again, but this time for Cell. And Harunagard is just drenched in Cell's blood as the tournament holders continue their countdown and stating 8, 9, but then out of nowhere, Cell immediately swoops on in, cutting Harunagarn in half. And as this happens, in a very brutal fashion, Harunagarn is split into two pieces. As Cell lands on the floor, we notice how the tournament holders goes on to state countdown for Tapion. As Cell states, he's not getting up. He's dead, as is his creature. And then finally, as the tournament holders reach 30, they go on to state 30. Victory for Cell of Universe 17. As Cell is also drenched in blood, he begins to walk away, as he states, "I'm going to wash up." But then Vegeta looks on over at Cell and stating, "Try not to kill your children on the way." As Cell goes inside of his room, he goes on to say to himself, "I've improved from this fight, but it's not enough. I need—" as Cell begins to change. Cell notices something as he goes on to state, "What? Ah, who's trying to control me? Me, Cell." As Cell is also being affected by Babidi's magic. As we see Yamcha walking out, he goes on to state, "It's the next fight. I'll leave you for a moment." As he notices the Supreme Kai also talking to Tien and Raditz, the Kaioshin goes on to state, "You would use this new power to eliminate the other two Saiyans?" As Tien says, "And the third one," with Raditz stating, "I cannot kill my brother, but I'll take care of him." As Tien also goes on to respond by stating, "So, there's actually a heart in this Saiyan's chest." As Raditz begins to get annoyed, the Elder Kai goes on to state, "That's true. You're not lying. You'd love to eliminate the other two, but fewer oppressors does not mean less oppression." As Raditz states, "Exactly that to me. Managing, ruling, and meaninglessly killing, I don't care for it. Those are all Vegeta's things. Kakarot and I will just keep enough to live and prosper. The rest, I don't care." As Videl goes on to state, "Oh yeah? Are you really going to stop doing evil?" As the Kaioshin says, "No, that's not what he said. They'll continue to kill and act selfishly, but only in their region on a small scale. They'd have nothing else to do with the mercenaries of the group of the four led by Vegeta. That's what he's saying. He's offering me a lesser evil, which suits his own ends well." As Raditz states, "Well, it's a good deal, isn't it?" As back at the arena, the tournament holders goes on to state the next match is XXI of Universe 5 against 18 of Universe 4. As Yamcha looks on over at 18, he goes on to ask, "So you've seen that he's a magician, and a crafty one at that. You need to attack him immediately, but exactly at the millisecond after touching the ring." As 18 ignores him, she completely steps in and charges directly at XXI. And in a very devastating fashion, the minute 18 tries to do something, she just drops to the ground. And it almost looks like 18 was rendered obsolete because we see how her eyes are beginning to change. Everything about 18 fades completely as XXI goes on to state, "Lucky, I was keeping the button pressed." As we notice him holding a button, Trunks goes on to state, "A remote! He deactivated her, but how did he get it?" As the tournament holders claim victory for XXI of Universe 5. And as Android 17 is pissed about to charge in there, he goes on to state, "You bastard, you're gonna pay!" as Yamcha stops him, reassuring that in fact they will be able to save Android 18 so as long as they act accordingly. As the manga chapter comes to a close. Now, we have multiple things happening in this chapter that really raises the eyebrow, Babidi having to control multiple fighters, we notice how certain people are acting very fishy, and all the while, Vegito, Goku, Vegeta, Gohan, nobody's really acting of suspicion because nobody else is noticing what's going on behind the scenes. Cell's being affected, Raditz is trying to cut a deal, everything is much more suitable in this manga chapter than how we've seen previously, and for me, I really enjoyed the Cell fight with Runagar because it really displayed a different level of power for both of them as we finally get to see what Cell is capable of alongside Harunagarn as well. So overall, this was a really enjoyable chapter for me, and I hope you guys enjoyed the same as well. Let me know your thoughts down below. If you guys have missed out the previous manga chapters, I will leave every single manga chapter that you guys need to check out in the description box below. Also guys, check out the official playlist of the Dragon Ball fan mangas. I will leave that link also down below. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed and cannot wait for the next part, slap a like down below if you guys are new to the channel. Hit that subscribe button, guys. Share this video out to your friends and family. The road to 1 million subscribers continues. Thank you all so much for your support, and I'll check you all in the comment section. Have a great day, everybody. Peace.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and all his social media platforms. Also, don't forget to turn on notifications so you can be the first to know every time that he uploads a new video.
Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god!
The fuck, Zarbon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes! Jesus Christ, that's huge!